Hello friends, welcome to E2C, which is Education to Career. So in this video, I'll be covering the most important current affair questions for CMAT examination part 4. So let's get started with the video. Question number 1. The National Payment Corporation of India has launched blockchain-enabled which platform to make payment fast and secure? So the correct answer is D. The National Payment Corporation of India has launched a Vajra platform to make payments fast and secure based on blockchain technology. The primary highlight on the Vajra platform is that it automates clearing and settlement of payment, drastically reducing the need for manual reconciliations. Question number 2. Which Middle East country announced multiple entry tourist visa to people of all countries? So the correct answer option B, which is UAE, the United Arab Emirates, on Monday introduced a multiple entry visa scheme valid for 5 years for all nationalities with the aim of turning the Gulf state into a tourism hub. Question number 3. The Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India has mandated all general and health insurance companies to offer a stated health insurance under which name? So the correct answer is A, which is Arogya Sanjeevani. The Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India has mandated all insurance companies to provide the Arogya Sanjeevani policy from April 2020. It is relatively cheaper and provides the option of getting a sum insured up to rupees 5 lakhs. Question number 4. Which among the following has unveiled a new adoption assistance program aimed at enhancing the potential support benefit for employees? So the correct answer is option C, which is PayPal, digital payment player. PayPal has unveiled a new adoption assistance program aimed at enhancing the parental support benefits for employees. The company said here on Friday, the new policy will offer financial support of up to rupees 1 lakh per adoption for adoptive parents. Question number 5. Which has become the first city in India to honor with Global Active City Standard? So the correct answer is option D, which is Bokaro. Bokaro Steel City has been honored with Global Active City Standard. Now Bokaro has become the first city in India and second in Asia to get this place. Kasarika in Turkey in Asia is the first city got a prestigious standard. Question number 6. Who among the following has unveiled the Earthshot Prize to tackle climate crisis? So the correct answer option A, which is Prince William. Prince William has announced what was described as the most prestigious environment prize in history to encourage new solution of tackling the climate crisis. The Earthshot Prize will be awarded to 5 people every year over the next decade. Question number 6. Indian Navy has launched an expedition Mahanavi Connect 2020 in which state? So the correct answer option D, which is Maharashtra. Mahanavi Connect 2020 three-dimensional expedition flagged off from Mumbai. An expedition to promote the maritime heritage of India and spread awareness about coastal security among the coastal communities in Maharashtra was launched by the Indian Navy on 5th January 2020 from a naval dockyard, Mumbai. Question number 8. Which IIT institution has developed a technology to produce hydrogen fuel from water? So the correct answer is option C, which is IIT Mandi. In Indian Institute of Technology Mandi, researchers have developed new material that can use sunlight for the production of hydrogen from water. The project has been taken up in collaboration with researchers from Yogi Vemana University, Andhra Pradesh. Question number 9. Which of the following organization has proposed to set up the Farmers Innovation Fund? So the correct answer is D, which is Indian Council of Agriculture Research. The Indian Council of Agriculture Research is all set to start a Farmers Innovation Fund. ICAR will bring a system to scientifically validate, scale up, and propagate the innovations of progressive farmers. As a part of this system, an innovation center will establish in New Delhi, where the innovations will be scientifically validated and farmers will be allowed to pursue research work. Question number 10. Scientists have recently discovered dwarf galaxies with massive black holes using very large array observatory. The observatory belongs to which country? So the correct answer can C, which is United States. A study found 13 massive black holes about 4 lakh times as heavy as sun in dwarf galaxy, which are more than 100 times smaller than our own Milky Way by using very large array. The observatory belongs to United States. Question number 11. Which state has initiated a project to save paper by using the digital medium for administrative to work as much as possible? So the correct answer is B, which is West Bengal. West Bengal has initiated a project to save paper by using the digital medium for administrative work as much as possible. Question number 12. India under Prime Minister Narendra Modi has been listed as the dash biggest geopolitical risk of 2020 by the political risk consultancy, the Eurasia Group. So the correct answer is C, which is fifth. India under Prime Minister Narendra Modi has been listed as the fifth biggest geopolitical risk of 2020 by the political risk consultancy, the Eurasia Group. Question number 30. Deutsche Bank has projected that Indian economy will reach 7 trillion by which year? So the correct answer option A, which is 2030, Indian economy is likely to grow 2.5 times to 7 trillion by 2030 from about 3 trillion now, making India the world's third largest economy. This implies that nominal GDP growth is likely to average just over 10% through the next decade. Deutsche Bank said in a research report, Imagine 2030. Question number 14. Who has been appointed as the chairman of an Apparel Export Promotion Council of India? So the correct answer is B, which is A, Sakthwil. Mr. A. Sakthwil has been appointed as the chairman of Apparel Export Promotion Council of India. Question number 15. State Bank of India has lowered its GDP growth forecast for financial year 2022, what percentage? So the correct answer is D, which is 4.6%. The research desk of State Bank of India has lowered its GDP growth forecast for financial year 2022 4.6% from the earlier 5%. The latest SBI EcoRap report even predicted growth rate to remain below 6% for the 2 years in a row. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.